Hello all, welcome back to Basic Electrical Engineering Laboratory. In the last session I have explained the theoretical calculation and the important specification related to the verification of KVL and KCL. In this session I would like to discuss the demonstration. Okay, before starting the demonstration I request you to go through the circuit diagram, how the connections can be done. So first I request you to complete the series connection. Afterwards you can perform the parallel connection, especially the connection of voltmeters. So here instead of voltmeter what I am using is purely multimeter by changing the multimeter into DC mode. That is actually the plan of action from my side. Now I would like to show you the demonstration. So kindly refer this particular video. Yeah, initially what you are supposed to do is just familiar what are the equipments. Now you can see this is your RPS. In that RPS there are two channels. This is your channel 1 and channel 2. So any channel you can use. Suppose if you require more than 60 volt, what you can do is you can connect these two channels in series, but that is not required for us. So I am using the channel 1. Any channel can be used, there is no problem. So here you can able to see these are the two knobs. Okay, this is for adjusting the voltage, clear? And especially set volt course means I can adjust the voltage in a higher range, like 1 volt, 2 volt, 3 volt, etc. If I want to adjust the voltage like a fraction, then I can use this this particular knob. So these are the two knobs which will be helpful for adjusting the voltage. I hope you understood. Now this is your current knob. So always remember that current knob should be kept at a maximum position, and these two voltage knob that should be at a minimum position. So these two, what I am suggesting you, that you keep these two knobs at a minimum position and this knob should be at a maximum position. This you are supposed to take care. Here you have to change the mode, either current mode or voltage mode. Please pull down this knob just like a push button. Okay, just like a toggle switch you can able to put in volt mode. Okay, just like a toggle switch. Now we can able to see the important points. This is your positive terminal, because in case of DC, positive and negative is matters a lot. This is your negative. Don't change the polarity. Positive terminal and negative terminal. Clear? Yeah. Till this you need to understand. And these are the indicators. That is not required for us. However, you can get the indication. Alright. And this is the main power supply. Main power. Initially make sure that it should be off. Clear? Yeah. I hope it is very clear to you. Let us familiar other equipments. We have we can able to see we have three lamps. Okay, look at this very carefully. Instead of resistance you can use the lamp. So lamp 1. Okay, this is your lamp 2. Okay, lamp 2. This must be the lamp 3. So these two lamps should be connected in parallel. That will be connected series to the lamp 1. Basically this is a series parallel circuit. Now you have to rig up according to the circuit diagram. That's why I initially remind you to undergo that, to go and understand the particular circuit. Now instead of 3 voltmeter I am using a single multimeter. Multimeter should be kept at in DC mode. So when the supply is turned off, sorry, when the supply is turned on, I am going to check the voltage across lamp 1, then the combination of lamp 2 and 3, so that I can able to get 3 voltages. Anyway, the RPS is having already display. Again, no need to measure the voltage across that RPS terminal. It's already we are setting, no problem. So you need to measure the voltage across lamp 1 and the voltage across lamp 2 and lamp 3. Lamp 2 and lamp 3, the voltage remains same because both are in parallel connection. Okay, so remember that a multimeter should kept at a DC mode. Okay, these are the two terminals of multimeter, remember that. Okay, now we need three ammeters. This is I1, this must be I2, and third one is I3. All ammeters are in DC ammeter, remember that. Now connection will be always starting from positive and terminating to negative. It's a DC supply, right? Yeah, so go through that. So the first point, it is directly connected to ammeter, so positive to ammeter. Ammeter first point, that means ammeter positive terminal. Okay, because DC ammeter means polarity matters a lot. The second point of ammeter will be directly connected to where the lamp 1. Refer the circuit diagram, lamp 1. Now from lamp 1, second point of the lamp 1, will be segmented into two. One branch that will be directly connected to second ammeter. Okay, now other point will be connected to the first point of another ammeter. This common plus means positive terminal. Now second point of ammeter that is connected to lamp 2, second point of another ammeter is connected to lamp 3. I think it is very clear. Okay, yeah. Now what you are supposed to do is these lamp 2 and lamp 3, look at the terminal, because these two should be connected to each other. Now from any one of the terminal that should be directly connected to negative of the RPS. I think the connection is very clear. If you having any doubts, you can ask with me. Okay, two lamps should be connected to each other. Yes, then any one of the point that should be directly connected to negative of the RPS. So the closed path is verified. We completed the closed path. Yeah, negative point. Connection starts from positive and terminated to negative. Now you need to power the RPS. Now you have to refer only channel 2. No need to refer channel 1. So by using set volt course and find volt course, I need to adjust, say 3 volt. I'll be setting 3 volt. You can set 4 volt, no problem. Please turn on the multimeter and don't forget to set the multimeter into you have to set in a DC mode. Don't put in AC. Please make it out a DC mode. Okay, you change it. Please change the mode. Okay, so I'm going to change. Whenever I'm taking the reading, I'm going to change. That's it. First, you need to measure V2 you are supposed to measure. Across the lamp 1, I'm getting V2. I'm getting V2 is equal to how much? 1.75 value I'm getting. So please note down. So 1.7, okay, 1.73. Please note down 1.3. V1 is 3, V2 I am getting 1.90. Similarly, V3 I would like to measure. V3, how much it is? V3, 0.99. Okay, 1.01. Some variations will happen. So 1.08. Now you can verify. Please verify. So V1 is equal to. So V1 is equal to V2 plus V3. I mean approximately it is matching. 2.98. I am getting 2.98. Clear? Yes. Next we are supposed to verify KCL. Now what you are supposed to do is by using RPS, you need to set the current of this much of value. Okay, I need to set the current is equal to how much? 0.138. I1 should be set into 0.138. Then I have to measure I2 and I3. Okay, so using, now I have to concentrate. For KCL, I have to concentrate ammeters. So now please refer what I am doing. So set the ammeter current is equal to 0.138. Yes, I have set. Look at this very carefully. Yeah, it is a lower scale only you are supposed to see. 0.138. Now you have to measure the I2 and I3. I2 will be 0.6. I3 also will be 0.65. Yes, 0.06. 0.138. Now you can refer once again. Yeah, it is very clear that I1 is equal to 0.138, I2 will be 0.06 and I3 is equal to 0.06. Now we can verify. It is approximately matching, right? Okay, so we can able to say that I1 will be equal to sum of I2 and I3. So hence it is verified. Some variations will be there because we are referring, we are using different components. Some errors will be happen. That doesn't matter. Likewise, you can set in different values. Okay, just verify it. Okay, this is the way how to conduct the experiment on KVL and KCL. So you need to go through the circuit diagram clearly. What are the apparatus required? Procedure should be understood. Then you have to verify theoretically and practically for the given circuit. Okay. And in this session, we found how to verify KVL and KCL theoretically and practically. Especially, I have shown this session, I have majorly concentrated on the demonstration. So, this is my reference. If you are having any questions related to the demonstration or theoretical calculation, always you can put up in the comment box. And any clarification, you can contact me through mail. Okay, thank you for watching this video. I request you to share this particular demonstration video, especially for the first year BE BTech students and diploma students. And I have one more channel for competitive examination, and please subscribe. Thank you for watching this video. Have a good day.